in more detail at pthreads when you have a mutex and want to wait. As in Java, you want to unlock the object's lock and be put in the wait set. In C and in pthreads in particular, the condition variable is explicit, so you have to use both as arguments to a certain function, and this function is the cond wait. And what it does is to both unlock and wait. It would be impossible to have separate functions for these two operations, because if we unlock first, then we might miss the signal. And if we wait first, well, then we are waiting and cannot unlock the mutex. So they both must be done with the same function. And some more details. One mutex can be used for multiple condition variables. And if two threads want to wait on the same condition variable, they must use the same mutex. And it's also legal to signal a condition variable without having the corresponding mutex. But that may not be the most common case. So, when we decide to wait for a condition to occur, we call this condition the predicate. And what this condition is, it can be just anything that computes a Boolean value. Okay? And what is important is that we should not check this with an if statement, but always with a loop. Okay, it may for some programs be sufficient, for instance, if we only have two threads, to use an if statement, but it's better to use a loop. So what we should do is to lock the mutex, check if everything is fine so that we can do something with the data protected by the mutex. And if this is not the case, then we wait. And give both the condition variable and the mutex to this function. And then when we are woken up and then we get the mutex, when we continue running, we get the mutex, have it locked. So then we should just not continue, but we should evaluate the predicate again. And possibly wait again. There are at least three reasons for using a while loop. Well, not just a while loop, of course, but a loop instead of just an if statement. First, these three categories. Intercepted wake-ups. After we have been signaled, another thread may take the lock before us. I said that when we leave this, we have taken the lock. The mutex. But some other thread may have taken it before us. Okay, and then there can be something called a loose predicate, which means that the predicate indicates that something may be true, but we have to check that it really is true before we rely on it. Okay, this may not be the most useful thing, but it occurs. And then we have something which is more of a bug. And in particular for Linux, it should never occur. But for some other Unix variants, it can occur. Or at least could. Okay, so a spurious wake up is that the thread was woken up even though it should not. We will come to why that may happen.